Welcome back to another Canon Review. I'm your host, Terry, and today doing a initial reaction for the new live-action Aladdin movie. So, real quick, won't do any spoilers. Even though we all know the story, there is some new things that they added, of course, that people want to know about, but I won't spoil that until the spoiler section. So, just giving my quick thoughts, I really enjoyed the movie. Really enjoyed it. I mean, I'm definitely gonna go see it again. But at the same time, I would say it's not better than the original. That's what everybody wants to know. But doesn't mean it's not good. I do think it adds its own type of flavor and it really tweaks it. That's the word I would use best, is it tweaks it enough to make it its own. And some of the things they add definitely make it distinctive for better or worse. So, but kind of going character by character, I think that's what people want to hear. Number one, you got Aladdin. Aladdin, I'll take the animated version. But I will say the live action version, he is much better than I expected from the trailers. And just the look of the guy just didn't feel like that was Aladdin. But he has a lot more charisma than you think he might. And he has a lot of talent. They asked them to do a lot. They asked everybody to do a lot, but him in particular. And so to find somebody that fits the ethnic profile you want, but also is able to have that type of talent, I think it's hard to do. So I commend him on that. I just think the animated one was a little more charming, but also it's easier to do that when you are drawing it instead of acting. But I think he did a great job. Jasmine, on the other hand, I'm taking the animated version by a long shot. And look, I feel comfortable saying this because, look, whenever we talk about any casting, I'm the same way about it. They needed to have a more true Indian or Middle Eastern, whatever they were going for, brown version of Jasmine. Because Jasmine is what I remember in my childhood as distinctively the first most ethnically diverse princess. And it's not that it registered to me to think that way, but it's just something that is ingrained in me. And so while I know Naomi Scott, the actress, is mixed with some type of ethnicity, I forgot, that fits the profile, she doesn't look it. She doesn't even look the same within anybody in the rest of the cast or her family. And so I do understand it, and I do think that she has talent, although she's not as a great singer as the animated version and all that. It's just, it took me out of the movie to see Jasmine, who you know to be this very brown character, not be brown at all, and especially compared to the people around her. So that took me out of it. And as far as some of the way they changed her character, I just still feel like she was stronger in the animated version. So Jafar, the surprise one. Everybody was ready to hate on Jafar. I'm taking the live action Jafar. I think the animated one was more muhaha, mustache twirling villain. And he was a bad guy, but this one is a bad guy. He's power hungry, just like Jafar in the animated, but he has reasons to be. He's a more fully developed character. And yes, the actor doesn't have the same voice, but man, let me tell you, the stuff he does is so much more menacing and cunning. And, you know, I just feel like he's more threatening as a bad guy than the animated. So the second best performance is Jafar by far. No pun intended. So the one everybody wants to talk about, how was the genie? Look, I'm going to say this. While Robin Williams' version is better, Will Smith is close. And they're so different, though, that there's a lot of things that they do the same. But again, Will Smith puts his twist on it. He owns this genie in a way that makes it completely his. And get ready for it. If you grew up in the 90s like me, this is now the new generation genie. And that's going to stick. And so even if you like, oh, Robin Williams is my genie, you won't be able to get the Will Smith genie out of your head. Not in a bad way, but I'm telling you, his performance, you're going to remember this genie. And I do think we're just going to have space for two great genies. And I don't doubt they'll do some type of spinoff for Aladdin 2 or do something with the genie, because Will Smith's genie is a crowd pleaser. they do a lot of the same songs, but then they tweak it and it's very different and Will Smith-esque. There's some new stuff they add with the genie that he does, but it's just Will Smith's personality and charisma is off the charts. So look, people are going to love it. I'm telling you that this is going to be this generation's and further genie. And so, yeah, at the end of the day, I really enjoyed it. I'm going to go see it again. I'm going to buy it when it comes out. You do have the moments that when they need to feel enchanting, they do. It doesn't feel enchanting throughout the movie like the animated, but it does hit when it needs to hit. And some of the stuff they do that's new is really adds to the story. Some of the stuff they do, and particularly one thing they do, is so trash, but I'm not going to talk about that to the spoilers. So overall, though, I would say go see it. Definitely go see it somewhere with great sounds, because it's a spectacle. And I think they infuse a lot of cultural parts that wasn't in the animated, and you want to be there to hear that and see that. So at the end of it, in the middle of Indiana where I'm at right now, people stood up and clapped, and I'm not making that up. People stood up and gave it an ovation. So yeah, people like this movie, and I think you will too. So go to the comment section. Have you seen it? Let me know if you what you thought. If you haven't seen, let me know if you're looking forward to it, and if you think Will Smith can live up to your expectations. Thumbs up, subscribe, share it around, and if you heard it here, it's official canon.